Hello everyone, and welcome to Sine of Our Time. My name is Bruce, and I want to warn you that this video is next level. As we have seen from previous videos in this series, synthetic division works extremely well when a divisor is of the form x plus or minus b. The question is, what happens when a divisor is not of this form, but rather of the form ax plus or minus b, where the coefficient of x is not equal to 1? This makes things a little challenging. Well, of course it does, since synthetic division is not designed to work with this kind of divisor. But that doesn't mean it can't be done.
Yes!
With a little bit of manipulation and a few extra things to remember, synthetic division can still work when a divisor is of the form ax plus or minus b. But it does register pretty high on the Sine meter. Let's consider this polynomial division, where 6x cubed minus 13x squared plus 7x plus 2 needs to be divided by 2x minus 1. This would be a simple synthetic division calculation if the coefficient of x was equal to 1. The reality, however, is that the coefficient of x is not equal to 1, it is actually equal to 2, which makes this problem a whole lot more complicated. It doesn't mean it can't be done though, and that is what I want to show you in today's video. Since synthetic division is designed to work with divisors of the form x plus or minus b, we can manipulate this divisor to take on that form. And what we do is we take out a factor of 2, leaving us with x minus a half, which is mathematically exactly the same, since 2 multiplied by x gives us 2x, and 2 multiplied by negative a half gives us negative 1. So really, it's the same divisor. We can manipulate this division one step further by writing the division inside brackets or parentheses, and then we can take the 2 in the divisor and completely remove it by writing 1 over 2 in front of the brackets or the parentheses, which mathematically is still exactly the same, since the numerator of 1 will multiply by the dividend, leaving it unchanged, while the denominator of 2 will be multiplied by x minus a half, which is exactly the same as the previous step. For now, let's forget about that factor of 1 over 2 that we wrote outside of the brackets or the parentheses, and focus just on what is inside of those brackets or parentheses. And as we can see, technically, the divisor is now of the form x plus or minus b, which means that we can perform our synthetic division process in the same way that we have done in the past. Okay, let's do it. We start by writing down the synthetic division symbol, and then at the top, on the left, we write down the value of x that makes the divisor equal to 0, which in this example is a half. And then on the inside of the synthetic division symbol, at the top, we write down the coefficients of each of the terms in the dividend, placing each in imaginary columns. And to finish the setup, we take the 6 and we write it below the synthetic division symbol. As always, we now just have to follow those two very simple steps associated with synthetic division, and those are multiply and add. So let's do it. Step 1, multiply. We take the half and we multiply by the 6 in order to give us 3, which we write one column over to the right below negative 13. Step 2, add. We take negative 13 and we add 3 in order to give us negative 10, which we keep in the same column and write below the synthetic division symbol. Back to step 1, multiply. We take that a half and we multiply by negative 10 in order to give us negative 5, which we write one column over to the right below the 7. And then step 2, add. We take the 7, we add negative 5, which gives us positive 2, which we keep in the same column and write below the synthetic division symbol. And here we go again. Step one, multiply. We take that a half and we multiply by 2 in order to give us 1, which again we write one column over below the 2. And step two, we add. We take that 2, we add 1 in order to give us 3. And now we have finished the synthetic division process. Remember that the numbers shown at the bottom of the synthetic division symbol represent the coefficients of the quotient as well as the remainder, where the highest power of the quotient is always 1 less than the highest power of the dividend. And since the highest power of the dividend is x cubed, that means that the highest power of the quotient will be x squared. And as a result, the quotient is 6x squared minus 10x plus 2 with a remainder of 3. Usually, at this stage of our calculation, we could just write down the results of our division and be done with it. But remember earlier, we were forced to make things a little bit more complicated by taking out that a half and writing it in front of a set of brackets or parentheses, which means we can't just ignore it or forget about it. We have to deal with it. And we can do that by taking the half and multiplying it by each of the terms inside the brackets or parentheses. So let's do that. We can take that a half and multiply by 6x squared in order to give us 3x squared. And again, we take that half and we multiply by negative 10x in order to give us negative 5x. Again, we'll take that half and we'll multiply it by 2 in order to give us 1. And finally, let's take that half and multiply it by 3 over x minus a half. When we do this, the numerator of 3 does not change, since it is simply being multiplied by 1. But when we take the denominator of 2 and we multiply it by x minus a half, 2 multiplied by x gives us 2x, and 2 multiplied by negative a half gives us negative 1. Now this is fantastic because this is the form of the denominator that was given to us in the question. Now, I really wanted you to understand mathematically what was going on when we performed this division, which is why I showed you all of the calculations to the left of your screen. But technically, we don't have to perform these calculations. There is a quicker way of getting to our answer. And here is the magic of this kind of problem. We can still perform synthetic division as we always have, but with just one added step. And that is by taking the numbers at the bottom of the synthetic division symbol, except for the remainder, and dividing by the denominator of the fraction that we wrote to the left of the synthetic division symbol. In other words, we take these numbers and we only divide by the number that appears at the bottom of the fraction, and we just ignore whatever number appears at the top of the fraction. All we really need to do then is take 6 and divide it by 2 in order to give us 3, which is the coefficient of x squared. And then negative 10 divided by 2 gives us negative 5, which is the coefficient of x. And then finally, 2 divided by 2 gives us 1, which is the constant term. And remember, we do not need to do anything to the remainder. And there you have it. Synthetic division works fantastically well when we have divisors of the form x plus or minus b. But as we have just seen, we can still make synthetic division work when a divisor is of the form ax plus or minus b. We just have to be mindful of those extra steps that need to be carried out. Now, why don't you practice by trying out this problem and letting me know what your answer is in the comments below. And if you feel that you've learned something valuable from this lesson, then please let me know. Well, that's all from me, and I want to say a very big thank you for watching.